and continue with 53, and then I will do the Parayanam next week for the whole thing.
Okay. Om.
Lalita? Okay. Namaste, yeah. Lalita. Okay.
Namaste,
Lalita. Right. We are going to go ahead with the Mangala Shlokam, okay. And then we will continue. Om. Gajananam Bhuta Ganadi Sevitam Kapitta Jambu Phalasara Bhakshitam Umasutam Shoka Vinashakaranam Namami Vigneshwara Pada Pankajam Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kama Rupini Vidyarambham Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatu Me Sada Guru Brahma Guru Vishnuhu Guru Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Jnananda Mayam Devam Nirmalas Patikakritim Adharam Sarvavidyanam Hayagrivam Upasmahe. Namaste. So we are going to continue with the sloka number 24 of 52nd Sargam. 552, and it is 24th sloka. Okay, we will see what happens. We know that Vibhishana was trying to put a little bit of sense in what he is doing, what Ravana has decided to do to Hanuman. So we are going to continue with that. Yeah. he continues. Vibhishana says, Mudaihi pragalbhairapi durvinitaihi yaihi vanaroyam purushaihi visrishta tesham vadartham kuru vira yatnam shigram vinashaya nishacharendra. So he's saying, oh Nishacharendra, oh best among the kings of Rakshasas, you should not take any action on this. Okay, the immediate steps you have to take. Shigram, shigram yatnam kuru vira tesham vadartam kuru. You have to think about the destruction of the people who are moodaihi by the fools, pragalbaihi very senseless, durvinitaihi immodest, insolent, immodest people, whoever has sent purushaihi by those men by whom this vanaraha, I am vanaraha visrishtaha. Visrishtaha means who has been sent to us by those insolent, senseless and what we call very, very arrogant people. Desham vadhartam kuru. You have to make efforts. Shigram prayatnam kuru, yatnam kuru, desham vinashaya. For their destruction only, you have to think of what to do at this point and immediately. There is no point in killing this messenger, the Vanara messenger. If you are a real true Veera and if you want to protect your clan being the king of the Rakshasas, you have to think about killing those people who sent this monkey. Monkey did not know. He has to obey the rules, so he is obeying. That's all. So you should fight with those people who sent him here. So that's how he tries to dissuade Ravana. After all, a brother, younger, though he is a younger brother, but he wants his older brother to be following the dharma, because he has many good qualities except for some shortcomings, as every human being has. Of course, this is the avatar rahasya for him also. So at least he is trying to dissuade, not to accumulate, because every karma will be taken care of in the next life. So he says, at least you have done enough papam as far as I know. So I don't want you to continue papam right in front of my eyes. I want to dissuade it. Okay. So in that way. So he is trying to advise Ravana. Reading of the 24th. Moodhai pragalbhairapi durvinitair yair vanaroyam purushair visashraha tesham vadhartam kuru veera yatnam shigram vinashaya nishacharendra. Then he continues, Kurushva tavat paramaprayatnam dharmam samastaya surendra shatro deveshu sarveshu savasaveshu daityeshu sarveshu sadhanaveshu. Oh, surendra shatro, you are the enemy of Indra. Surendra means the king of gods, his enemy is shatro. Oh, king of, oh enemy of Indra, you have to put paramaprayatnam kurushva. Tavat, indeed you have to put extreme, maximum effort. From where? Dharmasthaya. Okay. dharmam sthamasthaya surendra shatru. You have to maintain the norms of the dharma, the rules of the dharma. For that reason, you have to make extreme, maximum effort, because deveshu sarveshu savasaveshu, among the devas including Indra and among the daityas including the danavas, you know the best of dharmas. You are the person who always goes with dharma all the time, goes with dharma. So deveshu sarveshu savasaveshu, even considering Indra among the devas, daityeshu sarveshu sadanaveshu, and among the rakshasas, daityas including the danavas, you are the person who can really help maintain the dharma padam, dharma margam. So I want you to remind, so you have to parama prayatnam kurustva dharmam samastaya. In order to establish dharma or follow the rules of dharma, you have to follow this. I know you are the best among the, you are more than Indra and more than the danavas among the daityas. Even in spite of that big position, you know dharma very well too. So I want you to follow that path. Sloka number 25. Kurushvatavat parama prayatnam dharmam samastaya surendra shatro deveshu sarveshu savasaveshu daityeshu sarveshu sadanaveshu. Sloka number 26. Krutva prayatnam sudridham sushigram madvakyam evam manasa pragrihya tau rajaputrau vinigrihya virau jayam param prapsyasi rakshasendra. Please accept madvakyam evam manasa pragrihya. Please accept my humble words. Okay. And what have you supposed to do? Sudridam prayatnam sushigram krutva. You have to have strong determined. Sudridam means very strong determined effort. And also, so you have to make a correct decision. So, shigram, sudrudam, prayatnam. You have to make your efforts, but it should be for the right cause, the right amount of energy you have to waste. And also, you have to make a quick decision. And you have to listen to my words. Please, take my words into consideration. And then, and what have you, what are you supposed to do? You have to, rajaputra vinigrihya veera. You catch hold of those two heroic brothers who have sent this monkey, and then so they are the ones who are to be punished. So you have to bring the destruction. Vinigrihya jayam param prapsyasi rakshasendra. If you kill those two heroic brothers, then you will attain your jayam. There is no point in doing anything to this monkey. Your aim must be little higher now. Okay, so please listen to my words. And then, and you take your decision, because you are the king and you are going to take the decision, but take the right decision, and then you be strong in that decision. Nobody can deviate from that. So in that, so Kritva, so 26. Yes? Uh-oh. Yeah, 23, I have a different version. Asmin vinashtehi dandahi dutam anyam. Pashyami yattau nararaja putrau. Is that the correct one? You have that one? Yuddhaya yuddha priya durvinita. Adu ulle, yeah? I know. I don't. What is the next sloka you have? Nothing? Tau raja putrau? Oh, it is coming only at the 28th sloka. Okay. 26 I am going to read. 27th I have another sloka. 29th only hitascha surascha. Okay, we'll continue, no problem. Okay. Kritva prayatnam sudridam susigram madvakyam evam manasa pragrihya tau rajaputrau vinigrihya veerau jayam param prapsyasi rakshasendra. Then he continues. Parakrama utsaha manasvinam cha sura suranam api durjayena Tvaya mano nandana nairutanam yuddhayati nashayitum nashyukta. He says, Ravana, you are the one who brings great joy, okay, to the all the rakshasas, to the hearts of the demons. You are the one who always brings mano nandana. Mano nandana, for who you are bringing nairutanam. Nairuta is a word for the demons. You are the one who brings great joy to the demons. To you, Durja, these two brothers who are all we are talking. All right, it is not that difficult. Who are difficult to be conquered? Okay, what he says is, Durjayanam, Surasuranam, even by celestials and demons, whoever is difficult to be conquered, you will conquer them in no time. Okay, that is your position right now. How do we do it? How do we do it? Because you have that parakramat utsaha manasvina. You have high prowess, parakrama, and great energy, utsaham. And then manasvina. Manasvina means courage also. That is also embedded in your mind. So with all these three factors, it will be very, very easy for you to conquer anyone. Whether they are Sura or Asura, anyone you can conquer. Okay? It is not at all difficult for you with you. And it is not, therefore, what he says is, na yukta. Na yukta, it is not proper. Nasha itum, to eliminate, to what he says, yuddhayati. Yuddhayati means an approaching war you should not destroy. Because for you, with all your energy and enthusiasm, you can conquer anyone. But these two, Narapurusha, the Rajaputra who are staying in Kishkinda, they are happy, after all, human beings. You should not find any difficulty in killing them. So, and you should not, it is not proper to evade or eliminate a chance of Yuddha also. Chance of Yuddha is coming, so you should not avoid that. Instead, fight with those two people and leave this monkey alone. In that way, he is trying to advise Ravana. 27. Parakrama utsaha manasvinam cha surasuranam pidurjayena tvaya manonandana nairutanam yuddhayati nashayutum na yukta. Then the 28th sloka says, hitascha surascha samahitascha kuleshu jatascha mahaguneshu manasvinah shastrabhrutam varishthaha kotyagrataste subhrutascha yodaha. And in your position, in your possession, okay, you have kotyagrataha. You have so many, more than crores of soldiers are there with you. Yodaha, they are all warrior with you. Subhrutaha, they are all well-maintained warriors. They are ready to fight at any time. Okay, very well maintained. They are still practicing every day, and they are more than 1 crore of people. And then they are manasvina, they are all very courageous people. Shastrabhrutam varishtaha, they are all very good at handling any kind of weapon. So they need not worry, you need not worry about any of those people who are all always enthusiastic to go. And more than that, hitaha cha, they are all good people who always thinking of good to you. Hitam, shuraha, very valiant and very powerful. Samahitaha cha, and they are all very joined, and they all think and what we call with the good qualities. According to them, good qualities means obeying Ravana and they are thinking good for Ravana. So they have their courage, energy, and they are always they're ready to fight, and they are all with they are always thinking of good to you. Hitaha means they are always thinking of good to you. And then kuleshu jataha, and they are all born in good family, so they will not betray you. And then mahaguneshu, and they are all endowed with very, very good qualities. Okay, they are all born in a good family with good qualities, merits, and they have courage, they have energy, and they are all always desire to help you for your welfare. They are all working. So such people are there with you. What is the problem for you to fight with those two human beings? Okay, in that way he is boosting the morale of Ravana so that he will do something different other than killing of, I think these Rakshasas know they might, they will jump into conclusions very quickly. That is what the main fear of Vibhishana. Already so many bad things have come to Lanka, and bad things have been done by Ravana. He knows very well. So at least he did not want to add to that heap of papam. So he says, don't do that. So, 28. Hitascha shurascha samahitascha kuleshu jatascha mahaguneshu manasvinash shastrabhritambarishtha kotyagrataste subhritascha yodah. Then, he continues. Tadeka deshena balasya tavatke chittavada vadesha krito abhyantu tau rajaputro vinigrihya yudde pareshute bhavayitum prabhavam. What you do, tadeka deshena. So, what you have to do is, one thing you have to do. What is the one thing they have to do? Chitta vadesha krito abhyantu. What you have to say is, you go with a portion of your army. Okay. What you are doing is, you have to take one portion of your army and then you have to give them more training. Vinigrihya, subjugating those training. What you are doing, those two, tau rajaputra vinigrihya, you have to catch hold of those two brothers and then you have to show your prabhava. Bhavayitum pareshu, bhavayitum prabhavam. You have to show your prabhavam in order to protect you. You have to show your prabhavam to them, not to this monkey. Because monkey is just one who has been sent by them. You have to cut the problem in the root itself. Okay, therefore, what you have to do is, give your command. Ekadeshena balasya yavat, chitava adesha. You have to give their adesha krataha. What you have to do is, they have to follow your command. They will take a portion of your army and then they will send them to fight with these two Rajaputras. So that they will, Rajaputras will also know your power and you will also have time to protect yourself. Okay. So in that way you have to send few people to them so that they will understand what kind of Paurusham you had. In the meantime, you can prepare. One portion only you send. The rest of the portion you can prepare the army for the war. If they get rid of all those portion of the army, at least the rest of the army will be here and with them you can fight. So in that way, he was giving his advice. Tadeka deshena balasya tavatke chittavadesha krito abhiyantu tau rajaputrau vinigrihya yuddhe pareshute bhavayitum prabhavam. Sloka number 30. Nishacharanam adhipo anujasya vibhishanasya uttama vakyam ishtam jagraha buddhya suraloka shatruhu shatrur mahabalo rakshasa raja mukhyaha. So what did he do? Nishacharanam adhipaha. One who is the king of Nishacharas, the leader of the Nishacharas, that is a demons, Mahabalaha, very strong in his muscle power, Mahabalaha, and then Rakshasa Raja Mukhyaha, and the eminent king of the demons. Everybody knows Ravana means he is the leader among the demons also, demon kings also. Not only demons, many demon kings are there in different parts of the world, means he is a leader for them. And what he did, Jagraha, understood, clearly understood, Ishtam. Ishtam means whatever is desired, Uttamam Vakyam, the excellent message of, okay, who is that? Vibhishanasya Uttama Vakyam. Now that at least he realized the excellent message which was given by his own brother, Anujasya Vibhishanasya, his own younger brother, who gave the excellent message of to not to disturb this monkey, but you have to, I have to do it. And he accepted with his Suraloka Shatro Raswagriham, then Jagraha Buddhya. Jagraha Buddhya means he accepted with graciousness, with his due presence of mind, he accepted the good words which were given by Vibhishana. And we will see how he is going to act. And he is a Suraloka Shatruhu, means he is the enemy of the celestial world. Suraloka Shatru. Okay, he is the enemy of the entire celestial world. 30. Nishacharanam adipo anujasya vibhishanasya uttama vakyam ishtam jagraha buddhya Suralokashatrur Mahabalo Rakshasa Raja Mukyaha. Sloka number 31. Kim va Param Brahma Param Tvasahyam Sarvasya Bijam Jagatosya Vishnohu Yad Deva Devasya Paramcha Tejas Tadeva Teja Kapiresha Viraha. So the moment he accepted the words of Vibhishana, he was thinking in his mind, who this person could be? How this monkey come to my protected city? Okay, who this monkey could be? It is Param Brahma. Is he the supreme being who has been sent here? To Asahyam Sarvasya, because this is irresistible. He can tolerate so much of pain and everything. And he has been fighting. Nothing happened to him. He is just a monkey who is the embodiment of Vishnu. Jagatoho Vishnuho Bijam. The seed which has emanated from the Vishnu, embodiment of the what we call the radiance. Is he the person? Yet Deva Devasaha. Is he the best of the gods? Who is this? Can he be Parabrahma himself? Paramcha Tejaha. This is extreme power I could see in front of him. Tejaha Kapiresha Viraha. This heroic monkey, who could that be? I cannot even think. Okay, in that way he was thinking in his mind. And then, yad deva parandeva dejaha kapiresha viraha, this heroic monkey could be somebody. How did he come to my country? Those thoughts were running in his mind. So, he is trying to recall the shapam or anything. Of course, he knew the moment he saw the monkey. But he saw, how can a monkey do anything to my country? So, in that way only he is sitting there. But now, slowly after Vibhishana's words, he is thinking, who could this person be? Okay. Kim va param brahma param tva sakhyam sarvasya bhijam jagatosya vishnoho ya deva devasya paramcha tejas tadeva tejah kapiresha viraha. Then he continues, vadhaya me vaishnava teja eva disamshayo ayam kapirupadhari ityevam etad bakuda vichintya Rakshodipa Krodavasham Jaga. Vadayate Vaishnava Teja. I'm thinking that he must be the embodiment of radiance of Vishnu himself. Vaishnava Teja. Okay. Nisamshayoham. I have no doubt that he has taken a monkey form here. Kapi Rupa Dhari. This Vaishnava Teja, the radiance of Vishnu itself, has taken this form of a monkey here. For reason is, me vadhaya, in order to kill me. Iti evam etat buddhya vichintya. He was trying to think using his little bit of intellect, what is left in him. He could be that, So, baguda vichintya, various ways he is thinking. And suddenly, krodavasham jagam, rakshodipaha krodavasham jagam. Whoever it could be, how can I be killed? Suddenly, his mood changed and he became very angry. Who can kill me? With that kind of an attitude, he is thinking in his mind. 32. Vadhaya me Vaishnava Teja eva Nisamshayoyam Kapirupadhari Ityevam etad bahuda vichintya Rakshodhipa Krodavasham Jagama. Number 33. Krodham cha jatam Hridaye niruddhya Vibhishanoktam vachanam supujya Uvacha Rakshoti Padhir Mahatma Vibhishanam Shastrabhritam Varishtam. Now, Krodham, Jatam Krodham Hridaye Nirudhya. The Krodha, the anger which was springing up from his mind, he controlled within himself. Krodham Jatam Hridaye Nirudhya. He concealed completely within himself. He did not want to project that anger right now. Vibhishana Uktam Vachanam Supujya. He accepted the good advice of Vibhishana. Uvacha Rakshodipatir Mahatma, that great noble soul Ravana, spoke to Vibhishana, Shastrabhritam Varishtam, who is best among those bearing the Shastras, weapons. To that kind of Vibhishana, Ravana spoke the following words, controlling his anger within himself, because he did not, at this moment, he did not want to lose his temper and get into some other thinking. So he controlled that anger. 33. Krodham cha jatam hridaye nirudhya nirudhya vibhishanoktam vachanam supujya uvacharakshodhipatir mahatma vibhishanam sastrabhritam varishtam. Ityarshe Srimad Ramayane Valmikiye Adikavye Sundarakande Dvi Panchashas Sargaha. So we'll move on to 53. 53rd Sargam is named as Hanumat Puchha Dahanam. So Puchham is a word for the tail. So the Puchham is now given a punishment. So we will see what happened, what did Ravana decide. We know that by the caption, but we will go through in detail. Tasya tadvachanam shrutva dashagrivo mahatmanah desha kala hitam vakyam bratuhu uttaram abravid. Okay, so that on hearing those words of Vibhishana, mahatmanah dashagrivah, the great noble souled ten headed Ravana, desha kala rahitam vakyam. Desha kala rakita means it is at that hour of the need of the hour at that time, and also kala hitam, it is also for kind conjuring to the dharma rules what he is talking at that moment. He did not want to accumulate more shapam at that time. So desha kala hitam, which is the advice which was given consistent with the rules of dharma and also the need of the hour. Bratuhu uttaram abravit. To that Vibhishana, he replied. That is the first sloka of 53rd sarga, Hanumat Puchha Dahanam. Tasya tadvachanam shrutva dashagrivo mahatmanah desha kalahitam vakyam bhraturuttaram abravit. Okay. Samyak uktam hi bhavata dutavadya vigarhita avashyantu vadat anya kriyatam asya Nigraha. He said, what you have said is samyak yuktam, very befitting words at this moment, what you have told, bhavata by you, brother, I really understand. Duta vadya vigarhita, yes, to kill a messenger is very, very dishonorable and demeaning of our character. What you have vigarhita means a condemnable act, so I am not going to do that. What you have told is perfectly fine for me. I am not going to do the Duta Nigraha. Avashyantu, okay, if it is a suitable, if there is another suitable punishment, Vadat Anyaha, other than killing the thing, but Kriyatam Asya Nigraha, we have to teach this monkey that we are also equally powerful. At the same time, we also follow Dharma. We won't kill him. But for the destruction what he has done, we have to give him the punishment. Vadat anyaha. Not any hereafter no killing thing will come. Something else other than that, so that this monkey will remember for his entire life that he will not come back to this Lanka. Okay? To that extent, we have to remind him with a severe punishment. Sloka number 2. Samyak yuktam hi bhavata dutavadya vigarhita avashyantu vadat anyaha kriyatamasya nigraha. Number 3. Kapinam kila langulam ishtam bhavati bhushanam tadasya deepyatam shigram tena dagdena gachatu. Okay, as we all know, the langulam is equal to puchham. That langulam means that's a tail. Ishtam bhushanam bhavati vanaranam kapinam. For all the monkeys, they desire very attractive or very attached, very liked ornament. Bhushanam means the ornament what the monkeys is, the tail, their tail. So what I have to do, what I am tell, dipyatam shikram, let you turn, set fire to the tail. Okay, you have to set fire. Kriyatam tasya, that is dagdena gachatu, let him go with his burnt tail back to the masters, but we have to punish him by burning his tail. So set fire to it, so that, because that is the best abharanam or bhushanam for all the monkeys. So with that, when we put the tail to the fire, then he will have burnt tail. Then hereafter he will not he will not wag his tail hereafter here in our Lanka. So in that way we can do it. So that is the next punishment which will be remembered by Hanuman according to his conviction. Okay. Kapinam kila langulam ishtam bhavati bhushanam tadasya deepyatam shigram tena dagdhena gachatu tatap pashyantvimam dinamangam vairupyam akarshitam samitranyatasya nyatayaha sarve bandavaha sasurujjanaha. Okay, so the moment he uttered, okay, what he did was, let it become, he says, tatap pashyantu, pashyanti tu imam, let everyone look at him. Okay, so, pashyantu imam dinam, they all have to look at him and learn a lesson. From where? Angam, dinam anga vairupya karshitam. They should know that if anybody tries to wag their tail in Lanka, this is what the tail will be mutilated. Vairupyam, the rupam will be gone and it will become karshitam, means not even seen by his own friends and relatives. So, sa mitra nyatayaha sarve bandavaha sa sukrujjana. His friends, his relatives, his bandhu, and also good friends, everyone, comrades, everyone, we will understand that they cannot come and play the fool here into Lanka because all their tails will go through this kind of a problem. So they will understand what will happen if somebody goes to Lanka and try to show off their power. Okay, that's how they have to remember. So then, tata pashyantvimam dinamangam vairupya karshitam samitranyataya sarve bhandavasa sukrujjanaha. Sloka number 5. Agnyapayat rakshasendra puram sarvam sachatvaram langulena pradeeptena rakshobhi pariniyatam. Okay, what was he thinking? Agnyapayat, immediately Ravana ordered. What did he say? Agnyapayat rakshasendra puram sarvam sachatvaram. Okay, let this monkey langulena pradeeptena rakshobhi pariniyatam. Let this monkey be dragged among all the streets of Lanka. Okay, so that he will, with the tail ignited, langulena pradeeptena rakshobhi, by the other rakshasas, with a tail in flame, let them drag him around the city of Lanka. Purvam sarvam sachatvar, everywhere, wherever possible, let them drag him, so that with all the crossroads, chatvaram means the crossroads, junctions and everywhere, so that people can come and see what will be the punishment if somebody tries to play with Ravana's Rajya. Okay, so in that way, let them understand. Agnyapayat rakshasendra puram sarvam sachatvaram langulena pradeeptena rakshobhi pariniyatam. Then he continues. Tasya tad vachanam shrutva rakshasa krodha murchitaha veshtayanti sma langulam jirnaihi karpasakaihi pataihi. They were all waiting for this. Okay. Tad vachanam shrutva rakshasaha krodha murchitaha. They were all very, very happy. They were all angry and they were all very happy that Ravana gave this highly excite, and they were all langulam, they took the tail of Hanuman, jirnaihi karpasakaihi pataihi, with a worn out cotton cloth. Okay, they were all with all those cotton cloth, ragged clothes and all, veshtayanti, they started wind around the tail of Hanuman, all these clothes, and so that they are very krodhamu, they are all excited and at the same time angry also. Oh, our king has given the orders now, then we can play with this monkey's tail. In that way they were all excited and they were all angry also for doing such a bad thing in the city of Lanka. So they were winding around with the clothes, the tail of Hanuman. Okay. So, tasya tadvachanam shrutva rakshasa krodha murchitaha veshtayanti sma langulam jirnai karpasakai pataihi. Then what happened? Sambeshtyamane langule vyavardhata mahakapihi. Sushkam indhanam asadhya paneshviva hutashana. Tailena parishichyata te agnim tatrabhya patayan. Okay. Now the thing is completely, while this tail was wrapped around with a cotton clothes, okay, sambeshtyamane langule, when they were winding around the cloth around the tail, mahakapihi vyavardhata, okay, he started growing bigger and bigger and bigger, and the tail was also growing longer and longer, so which they did not expect. Then soon after, he was growing big and big, and the tail was growing. Sushkam indanam asadhya, as though the dry wood, how the forest fire catches with the dry wood, in that way, like how Agni consumes the what we call the dry wood, just in the spark of fire, in that way, enormous size, and then so the tremendous proportion. It was very difficult to for them to even wind round the thing, and the spark of fire will immediately catch fire to the dry shrubs of the forest. In that way, he was making himself ready for the next attack. Whatever comes, I am going to protect, because the as long as the tail is longer, the fire should not come near his body. That was his idea. Okay, the tail is longer means like a hose pipe somewhere at the end of the tail. If they put the fire, it will take a while for it to travel and come to his body. So he was, and body is also so big, so it will not hurt him. So he is managing right now to the proportion right now. So then what did they do? Tailena parishijya atha te agnimcha avapatayan. The third line of the seventh sloka. Next, Dhrakshasa soaked the tail. Tailena parishijya. Completely soaked the tail in the oil. Tailena agnimcha set avapatayan. Then put the fire in the tail also. There are three lines. Samveshtyamane langule vyavardhata mahakapihi. Sushkam indanam asadhya vaneshviva hutashanaha tailena parishijyatha tegnim tatrabhyaga patayan. So next, eighth sloka. Langulam sampradeeptam tu drashtuntasya hanumataha sahastri bala vriddhascha jagmuh prita nishacharaha. Okay, at that time Sahastri bala vriddhahascha, along with women, children, and even the older people, they all came out of their houses to see the tail being lit with fire, with the burning tail, and also Hanuman also they want to see. They drashtum, they were all eager to look at that Hanuman, which with the tail burning at the end, and there are women, young children, women, even the old people, everybody came out to see him with a burning tail. Eighth sloka. Langulam sampratiptam tu drashtum tan tasya hanumataha saha stri bala vriddhascha jagmuh prita nishacharaha. Then numbers 9. Langulena pradiptena rakshasan tan apatayat roshamarsha paritatma Bala Surya Samananaha. Hanuman was looking like the rising sun. The face was glowing in that fire. Even though it is at the end of the tail, he was glowing like the rising sun. And then what he did, he got into an angry mood. When the Rakshasan Tan Apatayat, Rosham Arsha Paritatma, he was overcome with anger, okay, and also impatience. And with his burning tail, he started pushing down all the Rakshasas. Rakshasan apatayat made the Rakshasas, because if they are afraid, anybody is afraid of the fire, right? So he was trying to wag his tail like a hose pipe. He was trying to wag his tail with the fire. So the Rakshasas who were holding the tail, they all started running there, okay? Running away from it. And that's how he showed his anger and also impatience. So in that way, he wanted to show them He can do this also. You take the tail in your hands means I am going to wag the tail so that it will wind around you so that you will also be hit by the same fire. In that way, he was trying to make the account even. Okay. So, number 9. Langulena pradeeptena rakshasantan apatayat roshamarsha paritatma balasurya samananaham. Sloka number 10. Sabhuyat sangatair krurai rakshasai harisattamaha nibaddha kritavan viraha tatkala sadrishim matim. Langulam sampradeeptam. Okay, he is, when pradeeptena sabhuyaha sangatai, what happened now that again what he did, they are tied down by the cruel demons now. Krurai rakshasai, this best among the monkeys have been tied by these people because he was trying to move here and there. They thought, okay, this one, he is going to create more problem to us. So they tied him around everywhere. They all came together and then they tied Nibaddha Kritava. When he knew that he is being tied, Viraha, that monkey, the great Harisattamaha Viraha, Tatkala Sadrishim Matim. He thought, he made his mind, made up his mind appropriate for that occasion. Because he cannot think, and that moment, presence of mind, what he could do. That is what he was thinking at that time, because he didn't want to think about, okay, when will this fire be put out and when will I jump to the, jump over the ocean. Those are all future plans. For that moment, what person, how could he escape from this torture? That is his main thinking at that time. So that is all, these are all the small information, or what we call the indications or pointers, as we say. Valmiki Mahamuni says how Hanuman handled this kind of a terrible situation. Okay, first of all, we cannot, who is going to put out the fire, where can I put out the fire, and how can I, that and all is too much at that time. What can I do at this moment? That is what is his main thinking. Okay. Sabhuyak sangatai krurai rakshasair arisattamaha nibaddha kritavan viras tatkala sadrishim matim. He was thinking, kamam kalu name shakta nibaddhasyapi rakshasaha chitva pashan samutpatya hanyata hanyam aham iman punaha. So it should be easy for me. Okay, kamam kalu, it is indeed, it is very easy for me. Dibadhyas, even though they think that I am tied down, though I have been tied by these cruel demons, the demons cannot do anything against my wish. Okay, na me shakta, for to do anything to me, na me shakta, they cannot do according to their wish and will, even though they have tied me. Okay, chitva pashan, I can cut all these ropes in no time. Samutpatti, I can again spring up in the sky. And hanyam aham iman punaha, I can kill them all in no time. It will not take much time for me to do that. And these people think that they have tied me and they cannot do anything against my will, even though I am bound by their ropes. They cannot do anything according to their wish. So that is very true, very sure for me. In that way, he is thinking in his mind. Kamam khalu name shakta nibaddhasyapi rakshasah chitva pashan samutpatya hanyam aham iman punaha. Then, yadi bhartur hitarthaya charantam bhartru shasanat badhantyete duratmanaha natu me nishkriti krita. It is easy for me, but I have come in order to help my master Rama. And then, charantam bhartru, I am moving according to the shasanam, whatever he has given me, the orders given by master, I am trying to follow. Okay, and then I am also doing some hitaharta, I am trying to do some good for Rama. In that way, these rakshasas, what is the use of killing these rakshasas? Okay, because if these people have not done anything to me directly. Okay, they are just following their birth through order. They are following their master's order, and I'm following a master's order, and I'm trying to do something good for my master. In that case, I should not jump out and then kill these people, because these people did not know anything. They did not know anything about me. They did not know. They can't even understand why I'm here. It's such Rakshasas mean they cannot think beyond certain level. So, but they are following the orders of their master. So I don't want to jump into conclusion and killed all these demons. Let me think more in that way, he thinks. Yadi bartru hitarthaya charantam bartru shasanat badnantyete duratmano natu me nishkriti krita sarvesham eva paryapto rakshasanam aham yudhi kintu ramasya prithyartam vishahishye aham idrisham. So if I do like that, sarvesham eva paryapto, I am more than enough. Rakshasanam aham yudhi, to fight a battle, I am more than enough for all these rakshasas. Nobody need to come here. Kintu but ramasya prithyartam, in order to bring delight to Rama, okay, so what I have to do, vishahishye aham idrisham, for this reason I will put up with all these problems, whatever is given by this thing, and I will understand what is good for my master. I have to do something like that. So I will put up with all these vishahishye. Vishahishye means I will put up with all these bad things, whatever these rakshasas are doing, so that I will be able to preeti artham, and I will be able to understand. It is a good reason that something is happening to me, means everything happens for a good reason. In that way I am thinking, we will see what happens. Okay. Now he thinks, sarveshameva paryapto rakshasanam aham yudhi kintu ramasya prityartam vishahishye ahamidrisham. Then he continues, lanka charayitavya vai punareva bhavediti ratrau nahi sudrishta me durga karma vidhanatah avashyameva drashtavya maya lanka nishakshai. Okay, so what is the thing? At night when I came first time, I've not seen Lanka in its full capacity. Okay. Lanka charayitavya. I have to roam about Lanka to understand the full power of the enemy. Where all things are hidden, where all the Durgas, like forts are kept, where all the weapons are kept. If I do go around with their help, because they know the city very well. So I don't know, I am a newbie here. So new kid in the block. So I will go with the rakshasas. By punareva bhavetiti, it all happens for a good. Because at night I was not able to see the Lanka. Ratro nahi sudrishta me durga karma vidhanatah. I did not know the secrets, the forts, the secret places, and everything I could not say. But now it is nice bright light, and I have a torch in my tail also. Avashyameva drishtavya maya Lanka nishakshaye. It is very, very important that I have to go to the Lanka, and I can see Lanka in that entire daylight. Okay, so I will have a good picture of Lanka. Then if I have to come again, when we come back, I will know the place. I will know the nook and corner of the streets. So the dragging of this rakshasas, they are dragging me, means there is a purpose for that also. So that's what I am thinking. I am going with these people. Okay, Lanka charayitavya vai punareva bhavediti ratrau nahi sudrishta me durga karma vidhanatah avashyameva drashtavya maya Lanka nishakshaye. 15. Kamam baddhasya me bhuya puchasyo dipanena cha pidam kurvantu rakshamsi namesti manasakramah. Okay, they think, that is what is it, baddhasya me bhuyaha puchasya uddipanena cha. For them, these monkeys, it has been tied down, and again these demons, they will torment me if they if I try to release me right now. Let them do, okay, uddipanenicha, let them do also the way they wish by burning also. Punascha, puchasya means let them burn my tail, how long it is going to do that. In my mind, there will be no shramaha. But I don't have any manasaha shramaha. In my mind, I am not having any fear, or I do not think that something bad is going to happen. So I do not have, intuitively, I do not have any problem in my mind. So why would I worry? Let them have a good time by lighting my tail. That after all, they want to do that, right? But if I try to go away from it, they will begin to give more torment things they will do. So let them do whatever they like. And they are not going to find any shramaha, any fatigue in my mind as well as in my passion, that I will not let it go. So let me see. So 15. Kamam baddhasya me bhuya puchasya uddipanena cha peedam kurvantu rakshamsi namesti manasakramaha shramaha tataste samrutakaram sattvavantam mahakapim parigrihya yayur hrishtar rakshasaha kapikunjaram. So this kapikunjaram, the powerful, great, noble monkey, they were dragging this great, noble and powerful monkey. Okay, but tataste samrutakaram sattvavantam, sattvavantam, very powerful mahakapim. Samrutakaram, they are all, and how did they go? Yayuhu hrishtaha rakshasaha. They were all laughing and jumping. They will just came out of the palace main door, and then they were all walking around the streets of Lanka, and they were all very happy they could catch the monkey, and they put the fire also in the tail. That is their achievement right now. So they were calling and jumping and hey, come and see here, this monkey has been caught, and see what we have done to him, in that way. But they are saying in that action, they could not understand what was going on in the mind of Hanuman. Okay, so 16. Tataste samrutakaram sattvavantam mahakapim parigrihya yayuhu hrishtaha rakshasaha kapikunjaram. 17. Shankha bheri ninadaistam goshayanta swakarma bihi rakshasa kura karmanam charayanti karmanas charayanti asma tam purim. Okay, so at the, they were beating the shankha bheri, they were all blowing the conch, they were hitting the drums. Nadai goshayantaha swakarma, they want to show off their great action, what did they do to the monkey, the cruel action, what they have done. They were all showing to the entire city, and they are all dragging him. Krura karmanas charayanti tampuri, and they were dragging him along the cities of the streets of the Lanka, and they wanted to announce people, even if somebody is inside their house, hey, come and see how what we have done to this monkey. And they were talking about their acts of Hanuman, and then they were telling, hey, this is the monkey who destroyed the Ashokavana, see what happens to him, and see what we have done to him. Like that, they were announcing, Goshayantam, announcing, they were dragging this monkey. Shankha bheri ninadaistam goshayanta swakarma bihi rakshasa krurakarmana charayanti sma tampurim. 18. Anviyamano rakshobhir yayau sukam arindamaha hanumans charayamasa rakshasanam mahapurim. So they were dragging Hanuman around the city of Lanka, about always all the city of Lanka. Anviyamanaha, what was Hanuman? Accompanied by rakshobhi, by the demons. Hanuman arindamaha, one who can get rid of the enemies in no time, yayau, went happily and roamed about the great city of the rakshasas. Okay, now it's a good chance. Charaya masa, he was given a good chance to look into the city in each and every corner. How prosperous, because he just had a quick view when he was jumping from the mansion to mansion before reaching the Ashokavana. But now he knows the nook and corner of the streets of Lanka. So it's a big, big help for him now to get into. But people will think, oh, he's feeling very sad. He does not, he cannot do anything. We have tied him. But inwardly, he was noticing everything. He was completely making a note in his mind. All the gateways, roads, byways, sideways, anything he can jump over, how the monkeys, if they enter the city of Lanka, what all they can do. So he got a very good picture of city of Lanka now. Anviyamano raksho bhiryayau sukham arindamaha hanuman charayamasa rakshasanam mahapurim. Then, ata pashyat vimanani vichitrani mahakapihi samvrtan bhumibhagamscha so vibhaktamscha chatvaran. Okay. So at that time, the great monkey saw this beautiful vimana, beautiful palaces, vichitrani, very beautiful architectured enclosures, and samvrtan bhumibhagan. Bhumibhagan, beautifully covered with the walls in every places, plots of land covered, and then sui bhaktan, beautifully parted. The divisions were also very architecturally, even geometrically measured, and then vibhaktan, then well parted. Chatvaran, the crossways, the shortways, everything wrapped up, and all the houses were wrapped up in all the beautiful gems and other things. So everything, Mahanuman made a note of those things. Atha apashyat vimanani vichitrani mahakapihi samvrtan bhumibhagamscha svavibhaktamscha chatvaran vitischa grihasambadaha kapi shringatakani tacha tata ratyoparathyascha tathaiva grihantaran grihamscha megashankashan dadarsha pavanatmajaha. Hanuman saw, there are three lines in this 20th sloka for me. Viti cha griha sambadaha. He saw the Pavanatmajaha, the son of wind god, Hanuman Dadarsha, saw, what did he see? Streets. Viti cha griha sambadaha. Lots of houses. According to the, what we call position, what a person is employed in the Rajya, in the Ravana Rajya, accordingly, they were all given living places, the dwelling places. Shringatakani, places with several roads with meet, you know, like a intersection, lots of intersections, and the crossroads, and then tatha ratyoparatyascha, the ratams and all can go, the chariots can go in that way, those places, and also grihantaran, even inside of the houses, some of the houses where they keep the doors and all open. Okay, so he wanted to see the central places with all the roads on all sides, the main high roads. Okay, ratya means inside roads, inside the roads, intermediary roads, by lanes between the houses, and then as well as huge buildings which resemble mega shankasham. Some griham, some houses were huge as the cloud, big as a cloud. And all these things he could see. And then he was going around and then see junction roads. Shringatakani means the roads which are meeting at the junctions. That is there. And then those were all seen by Hanuman. And he made a very good note so that he will know when he comes a second time which are the places they can take care of. So reading, Vitischa griga sambhada kapihi shringatakani cha tathar ratyoparathyascha tathaiva grihantaran grihamscha mega shankashan dadarsha pavanatmajaha. So I'm going to stop here. So we have done about 30 slokas today, 10 for the previous sargam and 20 for this sargam, because the meter was longer in the previous sargam and here it is little shorter. So I will do the parayanam of 52nd next week and try to complete the 53 next week. So then we will move on to the 54th sargam, slokas of Hanuman. Om atulita baladhamam haima shaila badhegam Tanuja Vana Krishanam, Jnaninam Agraganyam, Sakala Gunanidhanam, वानराणामधीशं रघुपति प्रियभक्तं वातजातं नमामि गोष्पतीकृतवाराशिं मशकीकृतराक्षसं रामायणमहामाला रत्नं वन्दे अनिलात्मजं अञ्जनानन्दनं वीरं जानकीशोकनाशनं कपीशम् अक्षं हन्तारं वन्दे लङ्काभयङ्करं उल्लङ्घ्य सिन्धोः सलिलं सलीलं यशोकवह्निं जनकात्मजायाः आदायतेनैव ददाहलङ्कां नमामि तं प्राञ्जलिराञ्जनेयम् आञ्जनेयमतिपाटलाननं काञ्चनादिकमनीयविग्रहं पारिजाततरुमूलवासिनं भावयामि पवमाननन्दनं यत्र यत्र रघुनाथकीर्तनं तत्र तत्र कृतमस्तकाञ्जलिं बाष्पवारिपरिपूर्णलोचनं मारुतिं नमत राक्षसान्तकं मनोजवं मारुततुल्यवेगं जितेन्द्रियं बुद्धिमतां वरिष्ठं वातात्मजं वानरयूथमुख्यं श्रीरामदूतं शिरसा नमामि बुद्धिर्बलं यशोधैर्यं निर्भयत्वं अरोगता अजाड्यं वाक्पटुत्वं च हनुमत्स्मरणात् भवेत्। ॐ नारायण 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 नारायण। ॐ त्वमेव माता च पिता त्वमेव त्वमेव बन्धुश्च सखा त्वमेव त्वमेव विद्या द्रविणं त्वमेव त्वमेव सर्वं मम देवदेव। ॐ नमस्ते सुसायं धन्यवादं। वी विल मीट नेक्स्ट वीक अट् 10 o'clock 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. बिकॉज देर इज़ नो संडे स्कूल नेक्स्ट वीक। सो आई विल सी यू नेक्स्ट वीक अट् 10 o'clock एंड देन हैव वेरी हैप्पी दीपावली टू ऑल ऑफ यू। एंजॉय द हॉलिडे फेस्टिवल उत्सवम दीपावली उत्सवम नरक चतुर्दशी गंगा स्नानम एंड ऑल्सो एक्सचेंज ऑफ स्वीट्स एवरी फैमिली शुड हैव सम good things happening in the near future. So I pray for all the good things to happen to all of us so that we can sing the name of God. Namasmaranam should always be there with us. Thank you very much. I will see you next week 10 o'clock. I will remind you. And January after maybe Sankranti week, I will there are some people interested in learning Saundarya Lahari. If any of your friends are interested, please let them know. Most probably I'll be conducting during the weekday, mostly on Tuesday 8 p.m. to 9 p.m. That is the time slot preferred by everyone. So please let everyone know. If anybody is interested, they can contact, I can give them my number, I can talk to them. Thank you. Namaste. Next week, 10 o'clock. Namaste.